My name is Earl Wallace Magnus. I was born January the 25th, 1928. My dad, he told me a lot of things about what was happening here.
When Moshom stayed with my mom and dad, I used to go and sit on the floor by his bed, and he would just sit there and he would tell me stories. He didn't really want to tell me too much about what happened, what he had heard, because he was scared that the family would get punished.
I was born and raised here. Four of us out of 12 did not attend the residential school. The scoop was still very much alive in the latter 60s. And I was one of them that scooped up from the cut knife school. But same afternoon I escaped, and I guess I kind of been MIA since. But not going to residential school, there was a benefit. There was a side of listening to the stories, listening to ancient language, being able to speak the language, wake up to the language, or, you know, go to sleep with the language, singing, ceremonies.
So the first thing I want to talk about is the purchase of Canada. Now, before settlers were here, we had the First Nations people here since time immemorial. All of this land that is Manitoba, Saskatchewan, Alberta, Northwest Territories, Nunavut, Yukon, this was all previously known as Rupert's Land.
My name is Jim Tutusis. This First Nation lawmaker, and the former chief, the late chief lawmaker, was my great grandfather.
In the meantime, Middleton has come from Batoche to Battleford, and he declares the Poundmaker is to come to Battleford and surrender himself. The police say that they bravely went out and arrested Poundmaker. But First Nations accounts say that he graciously surrendered himself for his people. Now, no story is more wrong or right than the other.
When I was chief many years ago as a younger man, we worked on telling the story of our community, because the only thing that actually, we had two plaques on our reserve when I was growing up, and one of them described Chief Big Bear as a traitor to Canada, and it was right on our land, right? And he was like our grandfather. And then the other one, and that was a Parks Canada plaque, very colonialist and very wrong. And the other one was just a small little monument to Chief Poundmaker, and that this seems to be a more deliberate and more a more charged effort than previously. I think the time has changed with Canada's 150th anniversary, with the Truth and Reconciliation Commission. So it's time for justice. It's time to straighten this story. It's time for Canadians to know this story. He was a great man. He was a peacemaker. My grandfather fought beside him. And, you know, it's something I want my kids to know. You know, my grandkids to know. I want them to know that, you know, Indians aren't, you know, on welfare, are poor and drunk. Society put us in those places, right? And that the way that we get out of those is having inspirations, having reasons for people to say, I have that courage of that man, I have the peacemaking of that man, I have the kindness of that man. And until we do that, you know, we're not satisfied.
My name is Darrell Poundmaker. I'm fourth generation direct descendant of Chief Poundmaker. And our plight for our people right now is to have my great-grandfather exonerated.